it's not the physical mon. A lot of people practice that physical mon, but that is kind of a superficial thing. It's a mon inside. He's mon because he's like steady, you know. हम लोग के कैसे विचार चलते रहते हैं कॉन्स्टेंटली, उसका माइंड जब कुछ कर नहीं हो रहा होता है तो स्टडी होता है. द ओनली रीजन वी हैव सो मेनी थॉट्स बिकॉज वी थिंक ऑफ द पास्ट, थिंक ऑफ द फ्यूचर, डिस्टर्ब द होल टाइम. एंड मुनि का एक और अर्थ बताया, यू नो सम लिटरेचर, की मननशील मीन्स द वन हु कॉन्टम्पलेट्स, इज ऑल्सो मुनि. सो दीज ऑल टर्म्स आर सिनोनिम टर्म्स, दे मीन द सेम थिंग. सो विद दैट बैकग्राउंड let's go to the next one. So now once he said ki okay, he's the one who doesn't have any desires in his mind, but then he's going to say open it up more and more, so that gives us some idea what he actually means. Okay, so this is verse 56. So whoever has the Gita, I'm just going to chant and you can just chant at home. Everybody on 56?
Yes.
Sukheshvanu utvignamanaha Sukheshu vigata spruhaha Vitaraga bhaya krodaha Sitadhimu niruchyate. So look at the Sanskrit words now. Dukheshu, in adversity, means jab dukha aaye tab. Everybody knows this word, dukhe, dukh. So, you know, since I'm doing it slightly differently this time, I want to talk about dukkha. Each word we will talk, because then you will feel more connected to Bhagavad Gita. Hamare zindagi mein jo dukkha aate hai na, wo Vedant ne teen cheezon mein baant diye hain. So every dukkha that we get, you can relate to one of them. And I don't know if you've heard of these terms. I know that Meena ji and Sushil ji probably have heard this. It's called Adi Bhautik Dukh, Adi Devik, and Adhyatmik. So what does it mean? Adi Bhautik means hamari surrounding se jo dukh aate hain. You know, like a neighbor ne koi disturbance kiya, you know, or whatever around, you know, household mein kuch, you know, gadbad ho raha hai and all that. जो पांच भूत हमारे आसपास हैं, मीनिंग फाइव एलिमेंट, उसमें उसके कारण जो सब गड़बड़ होता है ना, उसको उन्होंने बोला है आदि भौतिक. सो वी नो दैट वी गेट अपसेट बाय इट, यू नो, एंड इट डिस्टर्ब्स आवर माइंड. द सेकंड वन इज आदि दैविक. आदि दैविक मींस वी डोंट हैव काइंड ऑफ अ कंट्रोल, वी डोंट नो, सम स्टॉर्म आ गया नेचर में, या कोई यू नो भूकंप आ गया एंड ऑल दैट, वी हैव एब्सोल्युटली नो कंट्रोल. एंड दिस वायरस इज अ थर्ड काइंड ऑफ आदि हैविंग, यू नो दैट नोबडी नोज, इवन द साइंटिस्ट आर टोटली बैफल्ड एंड एवरीथिंग, एंड इट्स देयर, इट्स अफेक्टिंग द होल वर्ल्ड. सो दैट्स दैट कैन कम अंडर आदि दैविक. सो दैट कुड बी अनदर काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम, डिस्टर्बेंस, दुख. एंड द थर्ड इज आध्यात्मिक. आध्यात्मिक मीन्स कमिंग फ्रॉम विद इन माई सेल्फ. It can be my body giving me trouble, it can be my mind giving me trouble, my intellect giving me trouble, all that trouble that I create myself, you know, or I feeling myself in my own self. That's, you know. So, jab bhi wo ye dukh ka bol rahe hain, to just remember those three dukh that you're talking about. So, next word is anudvigna manaha, of unshaken mind, means this person. स्थित प्रज्ञ, मुनि, ब्राह्मण, जो भी बोलना हो, मैन ऑफ रियलाइजेशन, हिज माइंड डज नॉट गेट अफेक्टेड बाय दिस थिंग. सो वी कैन सी दैट हाउ अ नॉर्मल पर्सन वर्सेस हिम, वी आर कॉन्स्टेंटली गेटिंग बम्बार्डेड एंड बीइंग अफेक्टेड. बम्बार्डमेंट उसको भी मिलता है 100%. ही इज लिविंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड, सो ही गेट, इफ दिस वायरस इज देयर, ही गेट्स अफेक्टेड टू, और व्हाटएवर, यू नो, एवरीथिंग ही गेट्स अफेक्टेड, एंड हिज बॉडी अफ्लिक्शंस आर देयर टू, बट unshaken mind. And this is one of the most important one, you know, like steady mind means does not get disturbed. So that's how it is. And then the other flip side is sukheshu. So in pleasure, vigata spruhaha, without hankering. Means agar koi sukh aa jaye na, wo sab phool nahi jata hai. Because he knows that ye aana jana wali cheez hai. And we have heard this so many times. So, हम लोग क्या करते हैं कि वी वॉन्ट ऑल द टाइम सुख, कोई दुख है भाग जा भाई, डोंट कम. ही जस्ट काइंड ऑफ एक्सपीरियंसेस एवरीथिंग विद अ स्टेडी माइंड बिकॉज ही नोज दैट वी मे थिंक वी हैव अ कंट्रोल, वी डोंट. इट्स पार्ट ऑफ द नेचर दैट इज हैपनिंग कॉन्स्टेंटली. एंड देन वीत राग भय क्रोध, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन बिकॉज इट सेज ही इज फ्री फ्रॉम अटैचमेंट फियर एंड एंगर. So here, why did they use only these three things? Because again, every disturbance that comes in our mind is due to these three things, and they are completely related to each other. That's what he's talking about. Because attachment kyun hota hai? Because we have a wrong understanding of the world. So we get attached to, you know, our body, our ideas from within ourselves, and then outwardly we get attached to our house, our possessions, our children, our relationships. You just name it. Continue. It does go on. Our grandchildren, attachment, you know. But what happens from the attachment? Immediately, just some attachment hota hai na, the sabse pehle fear aata hai apne man mein. Oh my God, what if I lose this? And पहले तो अगर किसी चीज से अटैचमेंट हुआ तो फियर, इसलिए हाय मुझे शायद नहीं मिलेगा, वो फियर चालू हो जाता है. एंड देन ओ माय गॉड, वंस आई गेट इट, इट्स गोना गेट अवे फ्रॉम मी, फियर. सो नॉर्मल पर्सन लिव्स इन फियर कॉन्स्टेंटली, एंड वी हैव सीन द फियर फैक्टर इन अमेरिका, लाइक बिफोर इवन दिस वायरस केम, वी डिस्कस दैट इज सो मच फियर. द होल इंडस्ट्रीज आर बेस्ड ऑन फियर ओनली, यू नो. सो You have to be careful and all that. It's not telling about that. It's talking about unnecessary fear. Then, what is the relationship of anger now with the attachment? The moment I'm attached to something, and if I want it very badly, clinging attachment if I have. They're not talking about normal, simple thing. Clinging attachment. The first thing is fear. And then also what happens is, something comes in the way of me achieving that. And it doesn't have to be material possession. It can be, I want this person to behave like this. My emotions, all of that comes under that. The whole yard comes under that. If I don't get what I want, some object comes in front of it as an obstacle. Anger starts. Because usually, you know, we have this idea in the world, oh, that person made me angry. Don't we say that? He's saying, no. Nobody can make you angry. Your own attachment is making you angry. So anytime we are angry, you know, we can analyze it. What time pe we may not be able to because we are too much in it. But as we go away from it later on, just analyze it from this perspective that they're talking about in Bhagavad Gita. I am responsible for my own anger, because I want something so bad. So this person, the Chitta Pragna, does not have attachment, therefore he doesn't have fear and anger. So everybody kind of got that relationship, because this is a very, very important thing, you know. Stitta Dhi, we already know that, I told you that's the same as Chitta Pragna. Dhi means buddhi, or, you know, like your intellect, the one who has a steady intellect. So steady wisdom. Muni is sage. And I already gave the what Muni means. What happened here? One second. Huh? Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know why suddenly something happened. I can still see all of you, but you are viewing Joginder Kohli's screen. I think you have to do the share screen ko stop karna padega aapko. Joe. Somehow it went, he read something and it went on his screen.
Oh. What do we have to do?
Nothing. You know, you don't have to do, I think Joe did something.
Yeah.
All of you are seeing the same thing?
We're seeing you now. Oh, okay.
Yeah, now I switched to somebody else. I can see Meena now.
No, that's okay. Whoever is speaking will come. Okay, that's all right. I don't know what happened. If everybody can see me, I'm going to just continue. It's saying that you are viewing Joginder's screen, but that's
okay. I'll load again.
So, Muni, we already said, Uchyate, and now it became okay.
Yeah.
Uchyate means he's called that. Okay, so now who has a book? Okay. I'm okay.
Yeah, I have the book.
Okay, Meenaji, you can, since you came after so long, you take the honor of reading. Not Meenaji, sorry. Meera. Yeah. Meeraji, I'm sorry. You have to unmute, Meeraji.
Yeah. Sorry. Just wanted to say it's such a pleasure to be back and to see all these wonderful faces. So I'll continue now. He whose mind is not shaken up by adversity and who in prosperity does not hanker after pleasures, comma, who is free from attachment, fear and anger is called a sage of steady wisdom.
So now after I told everything, you know exactly what he's talking about, right? So yeah. Now we can go forward.
Okay. In describing the attributes of a perfect sage, having explained that he is the one who has come to sacrifice all his petty desires in his self-discovered self-satisfaction in the self, Krishna explains that another characteristic by which we can recognize a sage is his equanimity in pleasure and pain. If in the last stanza, Krishna considered man as an actor, herein, he is considering him as an experiencer, a bearer of body afflictions.
So what he's trying to say here is that last paragraph mein unhone bataya ki how does he, you know, uska mind kaise kaam karta hai. And now he's talking about ki jo humne jo ye dukh bola na, so bearer of body affliction, sare dukh humare body se shuru hote hain. Relationship wale bhi, we have, you know, somewhere discussed this. That all of our relationship is because of this body, right? The moment we quit the body, where does the relationship go? Boom, it's gone. So that's why he said it, the body affliction.
Okay. One who is a stable being, whose heart is undisturbed in sorrow or joy, who is unattached, fearless, and sans anger, free of anger, is described here as a muni, a silent sage. About the emotions that must be absent in
a second. Hila ji, can you unmute yourself? Okay, I can do it maybe for you. Yeah, theek hai, boliye.
About the emotions that must be absent in an individual who is a master in all situations, we are here potentially told only these: A. Attachment, raga; B. Fear, bhaye; and C. Anger, crude. In fact, when we read biographies of the perfected ones in the entire history of mankind, we find in almost all of them an antithesis of an ordinary man. The 100 emotions common to ordinary men are not at all seen in a perfect one, and therefore we feel surprised when the absence of only these 3 qualities is asserted so emphatically here. Naturally, a careful student gets suspicious. Has Vyas overlooked all of the other features? Can this be a complete statement? But on a closer look, we shall discover that he has not committed the crime of inappropriate emphasis upon the non-essentials, as critics have been tempted to point out.
Okay, so here, you know, I discussed a lot of things already. So now you know that why he mentioned all 3, because jitne bhi baki problems hai na, wo ye tino ki wajah se aate hain. Abhi anger ka bhi thoda sa hum log dekhe ki kahan se aata hai, ki maine bataya na wo attachment ho jati hai mere koi cheezon se ya emotion se ya people se. So shuru hota hai thoda irritation se, impatience se shuru hota hai. The impatience and irritation then turns into anger. Aur phir wo jab anger ko agar koi samjhe nahi aur control nahi kar paaye, so we know ki duniya mein kya kya havoc hota hai. People even kill, you know, people totally go berserk is because of सीवियर, तो जितना ज्यादा सीवियर अटैचमेंट होगा उतना ज्यादा सीवियर यू नो भय हमें फियर और उतना ज्यादा यू नो एंगर आएगा. इट्स डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू योर ओन अटैचमेंट्स. एंड देन देयर इज वन मोर थिंग आई वांटेड टू ब्रिंग आउट, बट समबडी केम अप विद अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल एनालॉजी, सी इफ इट काइंड ऑफ कनेक्ट्स विद ऑल ऑफ यू. दे सेड कि व्हाई इज दैट पर्सन सो एस्टैब्लिश्ड. So he gave the example of the magic show. कि magic show में जब हम लोग जाते हैं तो हम लोग कैसे हर एक चीज को देख कर एकदम shocked हो जाते हैं. Wow, like you know वो एक lady को card दिया जाता है ये वो right, and we are like totally shocked and surprised. But the magician himself is not scared because he knows it's just a you know maya. होते हैं ना दुनिया माया है. And the people who are working with him know how this works. They are also not surprised because they have identified with the magician. He knows what he's doing. So he's saying that ye jo sthita pragna hai na, he has identified with the magician of this universe. He knows everything he does, nothing is going bad. It seems like it's going bad, you know, to us from an, in our ignorance. So I personally thought an analogy was beautiful. So he's saying that don't get fascinated by, you know, magic, but identify with the magician. Then you will be totally safe.
In the previous stanza, we were told that he is perfect who has forsaken all cravings that bubble up in his mind. And in this stanza, asserts the mental stability of such a one. In the world outside, through our interaction with the sense objects, we can very easily realize that our attachments with things create in us the pains of the perplexing fear, phobia. When an individual develops a desire that is strong enough to make a deep attachment, instinctively he starts entertaining a sense of fear for the non-willing of the object that is so deeply desired, and if it has been secured, then again he fears for the security of the same acquired object.
So we already discussed that how the attachment leads to fear, because pehle humko fear hota hai humko milegi nahi, fir humko fear hota hai wo chali jayegi cheez. So that's where whole thing starts.
Similarly, when an object has charmed one to the point of deep attachment, and when fear itself has started coming up in waves to disturb the individual, then such an individual's attitude towards those that come between him and the object of his attachment is called anger. Anger is thus nothing but a feeling that arises within us because of our attachment to an object, towards an obstacle between ourselves and the object of our attachment. The anger thus arising in a bosom is directly proportional to the amount of fear one entertains on the score of the obstacle holding one back from winning one's object of love. Anger, therefore, is only a rag for an object expressed in an obstacle that has interfered with our love, threatening to rob us of the object of our desire.
So we discussed this also in detail, that how the anger comes is some obstacle comes in the in what we want, that's when come. Anybody has any question about this, because this is almost like a very basic theme now as we go to the other chapters, you know, the whole concept of where fear and anger is coming from. This continues till the end, this theme. So it's very, very important that we contemplate upon it and know. And one of the experiments we can do this ourselves is every time we get angry, think, which attachment of mind caused me to be angry, you know, and then we can, you know, work on that. And the other thing is Vitaraga is like a word, it's like a dispassion from the raga, because hum log ko kya hai ki in this worldly materialistic society, we are all constantly doing that get the things that make us happy, and whatever I don't like, get rid of it. दूर भगाओ, उसी में हमारी पूरी जिंदगी चली जाती है. सो बेसिकली व्हाट ही सेइंग इज दिस मैन ऑफ स्टेडी विजडम इज अबाउ वीत एंड राग. सो ही डजंट इवन केयर अबाउट द राग, That's the most important thing he's telling you, that because the moment you want just the things that you want, the flip side happens immediately. I don't want that other thing. So, and then a normal person, like one of the Swami said it so beautifully, we wake up with these three things in us. And we sleep with these three things. Hum log ko bilkul chutkara nahi milta hai isse pure din. Whereas this guy is like so relaxed. In fact, he went as far as saying we are born in all these things and we die in these things. So this is really, really important that if we can understand this concept, it will serve us. Even if we can get a little bit of it, our life becomes much, much better. And even current situation, you will stay calmer. You know, if you have not pondered upon these things, you know, fear is like moment you continuously watch the news, you will see what happens. It's only fear that is going to breed in our head. But if we contemplate something like this, even among the difficult situation, we'll be calm. We can make other people also feel calm. You know? Anybody has a comment?
Sanskara says that a man of steady wisdom is not distressed by calamities such as A, those that may arise from the disorders of the body, adhyatmika, B, those arising from external objects such as tigers and so on, adhibhautika, and C, those arising from unseen causes such as the cosmic forces causing rains, storms, and so on, adhidaivika. Fire increases when fuel is added, but the fire of desire in a perfect one does not increase when more pleasures are attained. Such a person is called a man of steady knowledge, a silent, serene sage.
So here it is Shankara says. Shankara is actually the disciple of Gaudapada who did the Karika. So Shankara, this whole philosophy, Shankaracharya ji is very, very important because he had the maximum commentary written on Advaita Vedanta. So I already discussed those three afflictions, right? Adi Bhautik, Adi Devik, and that also, that theme continues in Bhagavad Gita. So any question on this particular verse? Anybody? I'm just trying to see if I missed any point. We hashed it out pretty good. Should we go to the next one?
Yes, I think we are ready.
Everybody is very silent today.
Because we are on mute.
No, you can unmute. I said, no, I'm not. I didn't ask you to mute so that you don't talk at all. I just asked you to mute because the everybody's house
right,
noise
right, right.
Comes together and then it gets amplified.
Yeah, right.
You know, you can express your opinion or...
Did you hear better now?
We are all trying to be Stit Pragya today.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's you know, one very important thing that I learned, he's talking about Sitta Pragna inside our mind. You know, bahar se to hum bahut Sitta Pragna ho jayenge. Andar kya chal raha hai usme agar Sitta Pragna hue tab baat hai.
Nee, this seems to be the most important philosophy of the entire Gita. So I think we are all trying to absorb it. I think that's what's happening.
Yeah, no, it's good. I think even if sometimes we know it, but it's so good to go back and reflect upon it. Because at such times, it is needed the most. You know? Okay. So the next verse, abhi wo aage aage aur batayenge. Kya kya hota is sthita pragna mein. That's verse 57. Ya sarvatran bhisneha tat prapya shubha shubham nabhinandati na dveshti tasya pragnya pratishtita. So yaha is he who, sarvatra, everywhere, anabhisneha, without attachment. You know, a word hai Hindi mein sneha. So he's saying jisme sneha nahi hai. So don't misunderstand this. He's not talking about don't love the world. He's saying that usko wo is emotion mein behta nahi hai idhar se udhar se. Kabhi kisi ko sneha kiya, fir hate kiya, you know. वो डुअलिटी में नहीं है, दैट्स व्हाट इज बीइंग टॉकिंग अभी. अनभिस्नेह इज विदाउट अटैचमेंट. तत इज दैट, प्राप्य इज हैविंग ऑब्टेन्ड. सो हम लोग को ये जिंदगी में मिलता रहता है ना, दुख और सुख कॉन्स्टेंटली. सो दैट्स व्हाट इज सेइंग हैविंग ऑब्टेन्ड. शुभा शुभम, गुड एंड ईवल, एंड वी लेबल एवरीथिंग. Oh, this thing is good, that thing is bad. This thing is good, that thing is bad. He does not indulge in that at all. We are the one, you know, we immediately judge people and then we suddenly think, oh, I got to go and fix that person because he is wrong. He doesn't come from that plane. Okay? Abhinandati. Hindi mein word hai na, abhinandan karna. So, isko inhone bola rejoice. बिकॉज हम लोग जरा सा भी कुछ होता है ना, इंडिया में एक एक फेमस थिंग है ना, पार्टी कब दे रहे हो जी, यू नो एनीथिंग गुड हैपन, प्रमोशन मिला कुछ, पार्टी पार्टी पार्टी, बिकॉज वी वांट टू कंग्रेचुलेट कंग्रेचुलेट. ही डजंट डू ऑल दैट, यू नो, वो अपना मस्ती से ही थिंक ही नोज कि वो उसको अभिनंदन देके करेगा क्या. वो ही थिंक्स ही हैज डन इट, इज अ प्रकृति विच इज डूइंग एवरीथिंग, दैट्स वॉट ही नोज. बिकॉज यू नो समटाइम्स वी डू दिस एक्सरसाइज विद चिल्ड्रन दैट, okay, you want to bake a cookie, and when you started baking a cookie, now think about it. How many ingredients you need? You need those 4 or 5 ingredients, you know, butter and flour and, you know, whatever, chocolate chip. Now think, and then it cookie comes out really good, and then everybody, wow, you made a cookie and making so much big deal about it, which is fine. But if you go deep inside there, you needed those 5 ingredients. Where did you get that ingredient from? You know, from the supermarket. Who brought it there? If you keep going back, 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 farmer grew all those things. And if they didn't do it, you would not be able to make a cookie. You will go crazy thinking about it. It looks like the whole world has helped me to make the cookie. Because oh, transportation wala bhi. Road kisne banaya? Think about it. Bartan, ye, wo. I mean, you, tumhara khud ka contribution itna chota dikhega. And then if you didn't have the heat, you know, oven, and then if you go keep going backwards, who created the heat? No human has created the heat. It is, a, you know, some divine thing, right? Who created the seed from where the, you know, flower came? Immediately you get shot that, you know, my God, please don't congratulate me. I did nothing, you know? That's where this his idea is coming from. That he knows it so well. So the moment we have this feeling, maine kuch kiya hai, you have a problem. And you will see now in Mandukya Upanishad, I was absolutely amazed. Lakshan of Satyaprajna is in the next verse, 100%. Because he talks about that how the person does, he realizes we don't do anything. You know? That's why he doesn't rejoice. And then he doesn't hate. Because हम लोग ये दो इमोशन में सारे टाइम रहते हैं, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट और या फिर ओ माई गॉड दैट गाइ डिड सच अ बैड थिंग, यू नो कंडेम्ड हिम, डू दिस डू दैट. दैट्स व्हाई यू नो लाइक आई वॉज लिसनिंग टू श्री श्री रविशंकर जी, ही इज ऑल्सो लाइक अमेजिंग. ही एक्चुअली गोज टू ऑल दिस टेररिस्ट कैंप्स एंड ऑल दैट टू टीच दैम, एंड ही टॉक्स टू दैम बिकॉज ही वॉन्ट्स टू फाइंड आउट, यू नो दैट what is their mental state and how we can fix that. That's where the problem will get solved. You know, just to, you know, eliminate them and all that, that whole idea doesn't get solved then. So, usko wo jad se nikalne ki koshish karte hain, no, ki unke minds mein kya chal raha hai, usko theek karo tum. Tab apne aap wo terrorism khatam hoga, you know. So, this hate comes in our mind because of ignorance, you know. And tasya is of him, pragna, I already said, is wisdom. Pratishthita is fixed. So basically, his thing is so fixed that he doesn't need to congratulate anybody, he doesn't need to hate anybody, and without attachment, and then he moves everywhere. So there are actually this sarvatra ke do meaning hai yahan pe. Ek to ki har ek situation mein wo waise hi rehta hai. That's sarvatra. And secondly, very important thing that Swami is going to discuss here, कि एक तो है कि मैं, उसने बोला ना कि द पर्सन स्टेज रिजॉइस इन हिमसेल्फ सेल्फ में, तो बोला कि फिर वो उसको कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं होगा, ही विल गुफा में बैठ जाएगा वो. तो नो 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 नो, दिस फेलो इज इन द वर्ल्ड इन द मार्केट प्लेस डूइंग एवरीथिंग, एंड वो ये बाणों को सहता है, मीन्स अच्छा बुरा, you know, Shubha Shubham, Shub Ashubham, sorry. All of that that we face, he 100% faces that. He stays in the midst of everything and then keeps his mind steady. So he's talking about a person who, that's why they chose, you know, Arjun to give this discourse, because they chose a battlefield, you know, where people are going to get killed and big fight is going to happen. And he's telling him that be sthita pragna over there. So that's what it is. So for us, the symbolism is our battle of life. And right now it seems like the whole world is in battle. Unknown enemies, a battle, sabka chal raha hai. And it has crossed all the borders, it crossed everything. And the battle is going on. So I think the only people who are calm can even think straight right now. Because if you're not, then you start making bad decisions and stuff like that, what to do or what not. You know? So that's where it's coming from. Okay, so yeah. Meenaji, you can read now.